Man, them folk know I was going to go with Nike, man. Them folk, I already know, man. Fuck Jordan, man. Fuck Michael Jordan. Boy, I never turned my back on LeBron. You know what I'm saying? But we ain't signing with no Mac or Jordan. Goddamn, we ain't signing with no Mac. But we signing with Nike, boy. We signing with Nike, boy. We ain't signing with no Mac. With no Mac.
I love this team. And the one thing about them is they go out each and every week.
Why he stopped talking?
They want to make sure they put their imprint on this game. That's why they are top five offense. But it's all about the
top five
on the field. Yeah, I know coaches can sit in their rooms and draw up these plays, and they can be dominant that way. But if you don't go out and execute, you're in trouble. And this guy has played at such a high level.
Yeah, the thing I love the most is the consistency.
Bro, we top five. We number one.
A certain level of confidence in the entire team. But without this kid, I don't think they're there. But as long as he continues to go, the entire offense.
Man, the offensive train is rolling right
we
now.
We ain't top five.
He's explosive, and this kid is the engine in that train, dragging him down the track, and they're going to be special the rest of the season.
I love this team. I know that was something.
Everybody that obviously we sat together behind the scenes. This is a place where I feel like I'm at home.
Thank you, Pat.
Thank you, my family. I am so lucky that I get to do this. I will see you in a few months.
Put some Nikes on. I go put some knackers on. I go put some shoes on. What?
Thank you, Pat. The chat. It's all because of you.
This shit
so good. I've been emotional all day.
So again, this coming Saturday, ESPN College Game Day, live from Dublin, Ireland. Pat McAfee will be a part of the crew as he always is. Seamus will be the guest picker live from Dublin, Ireland as the college football season kicks off.
Well, I ain't got none.
Zero. And the good news that I can share with you is Pat's going to be back in January.
Just for that?
As
well, hell no.
Makes history, WWE makes
that's
history,
easy right now.
Things off live on
I ain't got no Nike gear on, boy.
So can't wait for January already.
What's up?
And I love everybody that was part of this together and everybody here.
Okay, look what you're going to miss next week on Monday Night Raw. We're in Providence, Rhode Island, and Braun Strowman has always had the
I ain't got no Nike gear, bro. Hey, can I do it one time? Swag Jerry Rice. I think I'm Jerry Rice. Swag Jerry Rice. I think I'm Jerry Rice. Swag Jerry Rice. I think I'm Jerry. Swag Jerry Rice. I think I'm Jerry Rice. Swag Jerry Rice. I think I'm Jerry Rice. Swag Jerry. I need motherfucking Jerry Rice. Swag. Jerry Rice. I'm not changing my shoes. I just changed my armband. Fuck this shit. But yeah, I put on the armband right here. You know what I'm saying? That's my Nike apparel. I got on my Nike apparel. I got on one funky ass armband. That's what y'all niggas gonna get. One funky fucking ass armband. That's all y'all get. Give me some free shit. Send me some free shit to work. Give me some new shoes with some red bottoms or something, goddamn. Nike. You see, I got all this new shit. I ain't trying to put on. Man, our jersey got all y'all logos, so what the fuck? So what the fuck? That got to do with me? Hold on. I think I might know a solution. I want to put the smallest motherfucking logo I can find. They ain't got no Nike on. Swag Jerry Rice. I think I'm Jerry Rice. Swag Jerry Rice. I think I'm Jerry Rice. Swag Jerry Rice. I think I'm Jerry Rice. Swag Jerry Rice. I think I'm Jerry Rice.
You know what the fuck going on? So yeah, I'll keep it like that. Got that OG.
Swag Jerry. I think I'm Jerry. Swag Jerry. I think I'm Jerry. Swag Jerry Rice. I think I'm Jerry Rice.
Oh no, I'm supposed to do it, man. I be forgetting. Hold on.
Swag Jerry Rice. I think I'm Jerry Rice. Swag Jerry Rice. I think I'm Jerry Rice. Swag Jerry Rice. I think I'm Jerry Rice. Swag. 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 Swag Jerry Rice. I think I'm Jerry Rice. Swag Jerry Rice.
I don't know. Fuck this shit.
Oh man, we playing the motherfucking Eagles, nigga. Oh man. Oh man. Oh man. It's about to go digital. Oh man, we play the funky ass Eagles. Oh man, big dog. If we play like we played against the motherfucking goddamn Dolphins, like we play against, if we play like we played against the Dolphins. Like, to these boys, the Dolphins, I mean, these motherfucking Eagles might beat them. Oh, God. The Eagles. No, they 4-6. Hell nah, y'all trash ass ain't gonna beat them. But we finna fuck y'all up. Y'all 4-6? Oh, man, never mind. Y'all finna get burnt. I'm leading in passing and rushing. You ain't never seen this shit before. McCaffrey only got 1,000 rushing yards. Boy, I got 1,600. I got 1,600. Pussy ass, boy. One of my receivers got 2,000 out. Puka. Puka. We finna get you, goddamn Puka. I need to get Puka the ball more, man. Puka got 12 motherfucking touchdowns, though. Y'all better put some respect on his motherfucking name. Puka got 12 motherfucking touchdowns, though. Hey, Puka, I need you to get that thigh out this guy. I need to set up some plays for my other wide receivers, goddamn. Cooper Kupp, you can go and take a risk. We saving you for a playoff. I wish I could do this shit. Hold on. Check this out. Put him right there. Put him in the number one spot. Like, if you was a coach, you would do this. That boy already got 2,000 receiver yards. Go put him. Go on, get him a little red. He's still out there as a decoy. You know what I mean? Man, we ain't fucking scared of no Philadelphia funky ass fucking Eagles. Nigga, fuck these fools. Fool willy ass boys. Nigga, we finna burn their ass up out this bitch. And we at home too. Nigga, fuck these niggas. Nigga, and it's a Sunday night prime time mother. Sunday night motherfucking Monday, motherfucking Monday motherfucking morning, early Tuesday. Easy like Sunday morning looking ass motherfucker. Oh, damn.
He is tied with Triple H.
Goddamn, easy like Sunday morning looking ass motherfucker. Goddamn, type shit.
He's in WWE, John Cena, Ric Flair.
Well, that shit ugly as hell. Oh, who did it? The
1980s. Could you imagine saying, you know what, I want to try to stand in front of the 290-pound Randy Orton? You know what, looks better than ever. Bigger than ever.
He does.
Randy Orton, who won his first world championship 20 years ago. The youngest man in history.
Bro, that boy Ludwig looked like a praying mantis, bro.
Saturday. Now remember how Randy Orton earned this opportunity. Back in Saudi Arabia, Pat, end of May.
Bro, be low.
Queen of the Ring tournament. In a controversial finish.
We're going to the 70s over here. We're going to the 70s over there, motherfucker. Over there, monkey funky. We're going to the 70s.
Mr. H, know that there was a mistake made immediately. You said you get your opportunity, and now it is.
Yeah.
What the guys realizes what this
why they got the same style shorts on.
You knock off Randy Orton one on one tonight. Big things are coming your way. 14-time world champion. Ooh, Kaiser.
Ooh.
We better get used to that. And he's been in the ring with Gunther. He knows what's coming his way.
Bet.
A week Saturday.
Nigga, we clean as fuck right now. We good. Let's get it.
Nigga, we got Puka, and we got motherfucking Coop, and we got Tutu. Nigga, we got Tutu, Puka, and Koopa out here. You think we ain't got the best receivers in the motherfucking league, nigga? What you thought I was gonna do when I got to the Rams, nigga? That's all they needed was a quarterback. What you thought I was gonna do when I got 2-2? Man, look at this shit. Look at this shit. I got motherfuckers. Look at this shit. I got goddamn 2-2 out there, bitch. I got Cooper Kupp out there, bitch. I got goddamn Puka out there, ho. Nigga, we strapped, nigga. We strapped. We strapped. That's why I do all this. Couldn't nobody do this shit for me. We strapped. Stop fucking playing with me. Dance on, dance on. Fucking talking about what they wanna do. They wanna turn this bitch up. We'll turn this bitch up. Your fault.
illegal forward pass, offense. Thank you.
Previous play is under review. After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
Thank you. Thank you. fuck is pain?
Man, this kid is balling. He jumped in the season, went to showing out, and the whole league is on notice. I'm telling you, everybody in the league is looking at him as that top guy for MVP right now.
Can y'all hear that? MVP. That's what he hears each and every week when he's walking in the stadium. In order to seal the deal and win the trophy, he's going to have to play consistently on a high level each and every week to finish the season out.
I mean, but you've seen this dude. There is no fear when he steps on the field. Whoa. Maybe fear in his opponents. We've watched him each and every single week dominate. And that's what an MVP caliber player does. But to win it, you have to do it all the way until the end of the season, and your team needs to ball as well.
Man, this kid.